Hello, welcome back to the Proactive Investors New York studio. I'm Christine Corrado. With me in studio today is Matthew Jones and Dr. Ronen Tchelet, both from Dyadic International. Great to have you both in today.
Thanks for having us.
Good morning.
This is part one of a part two interview that we have. You are ringing the Nasdaq closing bell today, so congratulations on that. So Matthew, I just want to start off with you from a business development perspective. Can you just kind of give us a summary of what Dyadic has been able to achieve since its DuPont transaction in 2015?
Sure. Well, in the last 3.5, almost 4 years, I guess, we have transitioned the business from an industrial setting to where we were making enzymes predominantly at a massive scale to a healthcare business, to a company that can express genes of interest for the biopharma sector. And that's been a huge transition for the business and for the R&D group. And we're proud to be here today to speak more about that.
And I just want to talk about one of the collaborations that Dyadic has recently formed with Sanofi and Mitsubishi. So you're the chief scientific officer, Ronen. Can you just give us an update on those?
Yeah, definitely. All those collaboration moving ahead according to our plan. With Sanofi, we finished our phase one and we are starting our phase two. And we are very happy with the communication we have there, scientists, that help us to reach all the milestones, and we're looking forward to reaching them. With Mitsubishi also, I think we have actually finished the first phase, and now we show them that we can have high productivity with their product. Now we are waiting for the evaluation of the quality of the product that we sent them, and we shall see from them.
I'll get more into these collaborations in just a minute, but Matthew, you joined the team in 2016. What is your experience been like thus far working with all these kinds of people within the team?
Well, I think the transition from the industrial setting to a healthcare one was really fundamental and a watershed moment for the business. We have attracted now some of the best talent in the sector in a very flexible way. The core team, though, is built up around finance. We have an expert in Ping. You're going to speak to her later. Ronen's team are world-class, and the collaborations that we've established, I think, are testament to that. And Mark and I, more of a BD hat, I guess, right? But we try to present the data we have to the healthcare community. We speak at shows, we speak in meetings. And we try to convey the power of C1. And in the last 3 years, we've had success in that message now being more widely understood.
Speaking of C1, can you just kind of add some more color as to how you choose the kinds of collaborations that you do seek out?
Well, we're not arrogant enough to think we choose the collaborations. We have a very strong work called cell line, and the applications are almost limitless, whether you're an animal healthcare company, whether you're a human healthcare company, and everything in between. I think where we can win here is by lowering the cost of goods. We have a very high productivity. We have a very cheap way of doing that. But we also have a very versatile, very robust cell line. And I think the work that's been done with R&D groups now around the world have further improved that over the last 3 years. And we share that data very carefully under an NDA with close partners. And so to answer your question, really, once we've done that, they're very quick to look at doing projects together, and we go on into other collaborations.
And Ronen, you're the chief scientific officer. So C1 is Dyadic's gene expression platform. So, I mean, what are kind of the biggest challenges that Dyadic is facing with C1 at this point?
Yeah, we had many challenges and we managed to successfully reach some of them. We are working on the others. And currently, one of the main challenges that we have is to show that we can produce monoclonal antibodies, for instance, with the glycoform structure that are similar to human types. And our first milestone in this case to show what we call G0 structure, and this is what we are now working on. And hopefully very soon we should have some successful results about it.
Can you kind of offer our investor audience a bit more color into kind of milestones ahead with C1?
Yeah, this is so far. First of all, we showed everyone that we can produce different types of biologics with C1, for instance, recombinant vaccines, monoclonal antibodies, Fc fusion, bispecifics. And that was to high level of production. That was one of our, I think, main achievements. And now we are working to make sure that we have the structure, which is human type of structure.
And Matthew, going forward, what are some of the biggest hurdles that you do face in kind of forming these collaborations?
That's a great question. I think the hurdles really are in our mind, quite honestly. The regulators have a position in healthcare, and we respect that, and pharma have a position in healthcare. I think what we're trying to do is bridge some of those gaps and reduce the barriers to entry in terms of alternative ways to express genes of interest. And we have something in front of us here which really is very viable. We're proving that. The announcement to our uplisting on Nasdaq is part of our journey, but actually these collaborations are testament to a lot of behind the scenes work that's been going on, both with regards to further strengthening the productivity and the robustness of our cell line, but also the conversations we're having at very high levels now with some of these companies in seriously implementing a cause for change. And I think we've been very public about reducing the cost of healthcare as being a very highly motivating statement from Dyadic, and we believe that very passionately. Right through the whole office, actually, we have in Florida, and all the team we have there believe very strongly in making a difference. And so that passion comes through. Of course, in the science, we're seeing now announcements being made through this year and last year. And as we go forwards, you'll see more. So I think we try to choose our collaborations very carefully, but we're also looking to fundamentally make a shift now in the cost of goods for healthcare.
Well, Matthew, Ronen, it was great to have you in today. Have a great time at the Nasdaq closing bell today.
Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.